Bushfires are raging out of control in Victoria's west.
Some residents in the Grampians have been told it is too late to leave. Amber Johnston is there tonight. Amber, you have breaking news.
I do, Alicia. The CFA has just confirmed the news we were all dreading today, that homes have in fact been lost in Pomonal, just south of Halls Gap. It's actually where the bushfire is burning just behind me. We were there earlier today but had to retreat to a safer spot here in Store when the winds changed and the situation became incredibly dangerous. There's actually a second bushfire burning out of control just to the north of the Grampians National Park. That is threatening homes near Horsham. I'm sure you can probably tell conditions are horrendous tonight. It's still incredibly windy and also really hot, so needless to say, crews are not out of the woods just yet.
In the Grampians National Park, firefighters face a monstrous battle being fought from above. A fast-moving bushfire whipped up by a sudden wind change with gusts of more than 100 kilometres an hour, putting homes in the firing line.
We're just out here just putting sprinklers around and haven't packed or anything like that. Probably should, but haven't.
Noah and his father decided to stay and defend their property in Pomonal, but this afternoon the decision was taken out of their hands. Residents in town south of Halls Gap told it's too late to leave.
It wasn't so much of a worry today, and then you better leave. So we started evacuating, and then I said, no, seriously, get out.
It's a gut-wrenching case of deja vu for the people of Pomonal and other neighbouring towns that have been ravaged by bushfires over the years. And now another fire emergency.
Just keen on just fighting. Just built this house a couple of years ago, so yeah, we just really want to, save it, I guess.
Conditions deteriorated as the day went on, with temperatures soaring above 40 degrees, coupled with extreme wind gusts, leaving even the most experienced firefighters fearing the worst.
Those fires have the potential to get big and to put lives at risk.
The challenge for crews is access, with the dense national park making it almost impossible to tackle on the ground and almost as difficult from above.
Aircraft are effective to a point where the wind speeds start to become a challenge. We have seen a number of times throughout today where aircraft were not able to fly.
Children in the Wimmera region were told to stay at home, with 55 local schools forced to shut their doors along with campsites. Tourists warned to get out immediately.
I just ran around just frantically, just said, you've got to go. And they're like, now? I said, yep, now.
It's the first time in 4 years Victoria has issued a catastrophic fire warning.
Our thoughts are with all those who are on the ground doing that work today. May they be able to bring all those fires under control.
And as time passes, it doesn't get easier for crews or for locals.
There's an old man up here who's lost his house and he's just sitting up here. Pretty devastating.
Amber Johnston, Nine News.
OK, let's get a live update now on this bushfire emergency from the State Control Centre, and that is where we find CFA Chief Officer Jason Heffernan. Jason, thanks for your time. We've just heard that homes have been lost from our reporter who's there. Which areas are of most concern to you right now?
The fire situation across Victoria, and particularly the western part of the state, is still very concerning for us here at the State Control Centre. Firefighters have been battling fire all day. Those winds have been relentless. They continue to blow and will continue to blow for some hours now. Those warm temperatures are still in existence, around 30 degrees in the fire-affected area. Two fires of concern for myself this evening as we head into the night for the Grampians National Park, the first one being the Belfield Fire. It is at emergency warning, too late to leave. Shelter now is the message given to those residents, in particular for Belfield, Lake Fellands and Pomonal. The fire is heading through Pomonal as we speak. We are getting early reports of some property losses there. Crews are actively engaged in property protection and also seeking to protect a number of community members that have sought refuge on the oval there in the village. It is a very dynamic situation that is occurring there in Pomonal, and we're really watching that at the moment. That fire earlier this afternoon was around 100 hectares. It's now out to 863 hectares and continues to grow under those westerly winds. The second fire, the Mount Stapleton fire, took a significant run this afternoon. It's around 742 hectares. It's at an emergency warning level. It's not under control. And for people in Dadswells Bridge, Glenorchy, Ledcourt, Roses Gap, St Helens Plains and Walwal, it is too late for you to leave and you're to take shelter now. It's a very dangerous situation across those fire grounds. Firefighters are doing their best, community is doing their best, and we're hoping that with the next couple of hours we can get through with these winds sustaining.
A busy night ahead for you, Jason Heffernan, CFA's Chief Officer. Thanks for your time tonight.